some of us was in the Second Kansas Colored. We fought the Rebs at Jenkins Ferry last April, just after they killed every Negro soldier they captured at Poison Springs. So at Jenkins Ferry, we decided we weren't taking no Reb prisoners, and we didn't leave one of them alive. The ones of us that didn't die that day, we joined up with the 116th U.S. Colored, sir, from Camp Nelson, Kentucky.
What's your name, soldier?
Private Harold Green, sir.
I'm Corporal Ira Clark, sir, 5th Massachusetts Cavalry. We're waiting over there. We're leaving our horses behind and shipping out with the 24th Infantry for the assault next week on Wilmington.
How long have you been a soldier?
2 years, sir.
2nd Kansas Colored Infantry, they fought bravely at Jenkins Ferry.
That's right, sir.
They killed 1,000 rebel soldiers, sir. They were very brave. And making $3 less each month than white soldiers.
That's 2nd Kansas, boys.
Another $3 subtracted from our pay for our uniforms.
That was true, yes, sir.
Equal pay now, but still no commissioned Negro officers.
I'm aware of that, Corporal Clark.
Yes, sir. That's good that you're aware, sir. It's only
that... Do you think the Wilmington attack...
Now that white people have accustomed themselves to seeing Negro men with guns fighting on their behalf, and now that they can tolerate Negro soldiers getting equal pay, maybe in a few years they can abide the idea of Negro lieutenants and captains. In 50 years, maybe a Negro colonel. In 100 years, the vote.
What would you do after the war?
Work, sir. Perhaps you'll hire me.
Perhaps I will.
But you should know, sir, that I get sick at the smell of boot black and I cannot cut hair.
I've yet to find a man who could cut mine so it would make any difference.
You got spring of hair for a white man.
I do. My last barber hanged himself. And the one before that. Left me his scissors in his will.